You're watching Colorado in the Wild. Brought to you by Daily Real Estate, your home and ranch specialist. Full Rut Archery. Tightline Outdoors with Nathan Zielinski. And by Rocky Mountain Roosters, Colorado's finest private pheasant hunting preserve.
Now folks, if you like fly fishing, we're going to be up on the North Fork of the South Platte River right here in Colorado, fishing at Dan Moret's place. It's the Boxwood Gulch Ranch. And we'll be catching a lot of fish. We're with my son, and we're with my granddaughter and some other buddies. We're going to be catching a lot of them. Then we're going to be elk hunting.
Then we'll be at Rocky Mountain Roosters with some of our military bird hunting. But first, what do you say let's go do some trout fishing? This section of the Platte River is located west of Bailey, Colorado. And this is Kayla's first fly fishing trip.
So scoot back, just back in here with me a little bit.
All right. Yeah, you help her.
When you get your drift done here, you got to go underneath the tree, so you got to kind of watch that, okay? You're going to throw it right up in here. Okay? See where that's kind of brown and it goes into green water? Okay, that's kind of that shelf line there. So you're just going to pick up and baseball up into there. You're going to have to kind of watch the tree here a little bit. But good, put that come down.
Oh.
Nice.
That's a fish right there.
Here. Really.
Tip up.
All right, let it there we go.
Let go the reel. Hold on to the pole. Now reel.
Nice job, Kayla.
Now reel.
Nice
tip
work.
Up.
Okay, now when you feel a lot of pressure, take your hand off that reel.
Yeah. If it's pulling, take it off the reel.
Because I put a smaller pound test on there.
Let it play.
You keep see what we're saying, up. Caleb? See how that line's spinning out of there?
Let it go.
Reel. Don't let him have that much slack. You're letting him have too much slack.
Now let him go.
I did.
Oh, there we go.
Hold on. Okay, we're good.
Oh, well, get my.
Tip up. Let it play.
You keep see what we're saying, up. Caleb? See how that line's spinning out of there?
Let it.
Hey, stop reeling right there. Keep your rod high. I want you to swim back slowly here. Okay, now he may run on you again. Just
let him
ready.
Let him run.
We'll be back after the break with more fly fishing on the North Fork of the South Platte River.
Hunters, the best pheasant hunting this season isn't in Kansas or Nebraska. For the best upland bird hunting, the only choice is Rocky Mountain Roosters. Rocky Mountain Roosters has 5,000 acres, experienced guides and dogs, and we have pheasants, chucker, and quail. Since 1985, I've been telling you about Colorado's finest private pheasant hunting preserve, and it's just 30 miles east of Colorado Springs. At Rocky Mountain Roosters, you'll see more pheasants in 1 year than most hunters see in a lifetime. See us on the web at rmroosters.com.
Oh, that's a nice one, Kayla.
Hey, great job playing him. You let him go when he needed to, and that's why you got him. It's a good job. So we just had to go a lot smaller there on fly size. You know, they've seen everything, so that's why we just went smaller and boom. You know, so when you're out in the river and you're not catching a fish, it changes everything, you know.
Oh, that's a healthy looking fish, ain't it?
All right, I'll get a picture.
Okay, Kayla, hand me your rod.
Here, give me that.
Okay, let's give him a drink of water here. Okay.
Switch down.
Let's give him a second here and let him kind of revive here. Okay. One thing we don't want to hurt him for sure.
Here, okay. Let me take that pole anyway.
I'll hold the net and then go ahead and pick that up, Kayla, and you get your picture, and I'll hold the net under him in case you drop him.
Both hands, underneath.
Let me drop underneath. That net for you a little bit.
Both hands.
I got him. I was just trying to help you out there a little bit. Watch out, they bite.
Oh, they do?
No.
Oh, scared me. I was like,
both hands.
Have you noticed underneath. I'm missing part of my finger?
Right there. There you go. Now look at me.
All right, now wait.
Hold him back towards you.
All right, now put him right there in that shallow water with that camera.
Put him in the water.
Let it go. Now hold on to it. Did it take off?
Now, folks, if you're looking for one of the most prestigious places to live in the city of Castle Rock, it's right here at the Pinion Soleil area. It's right off of Founders. We have got a wonderful home with views. And of course, you can see here the caliber of a home it is. It's got an entry gate into your three-car attached garage and your double detached garage. And folks, as you can see, the guys are just now finishing the yard work up. This home is ready to buy right now. Folks, one of the cool things about a home in this class is when you walk into the main level, the first thing you see, of course, is over here at the study. And for this kind of home, you'd expect some surprises. In the wall here, you take off the magnet board and you open up your own little private closet here for whatever use you might want that for. And then you continue down the hallway here into the great room, and over to your right is a large fireplace. The ceiling looks like it's maybe 20 feet or more. Let's go straight to the kitchen. This is something that most everybody will enjoy. If you're a cook, you got this, a leather type granite 12 foot island here. Vegetable sink here comes complete with, of course, the pot filler. You can reach over here and fill pots on your 4 foot, 6 burner decor oven stove with a griddle on top, and one of the most powerful suction devices available to the outside. This kitchen was made to entertain. Now, still on the same level, right off the kitchen, is a huge covered deck out here, complete with your table. And folks, the views, I mean, this is a rare piece of property sitting right here. Castle Rock is about a mile, the main part of Castle Rock where the Target stores and all are. I-25 is right down there, but look here, look at the views. Back in the home, you have a butler's pantry, a formal dining room. The master bedroom has all the views you want. Fireplace and a door to your veranda. You'd expect a large tub with a shower and a walk-in closet bigger than most folks' bedrooms. Now upstairs you have 3 private suites with the views. You know, a home of this caliber wouldn't be complete without a playroom downstairs with a walkout basement part complete with a media room. Now folks, downstairs it also has 2 bedrooms, a bath and a half, and the wet bar.
Well, Rocky Mountain Roosters has been around since 1985. Started it when I got out of college, and we've got 5,000 acres here, strictly for upland bird hunting. We got pheasants, chucker, and quail. And so it's a public-private facility. We have memberships available, but we allow people to come out one time a year so they can experience upland bird hunting in Colorado without having to drive to Kansas or South Dakota to get into good shooting. So, you know, we're about an hour south of Denver, half hour east of Colorado Springs. So it gives people a chance to get into a lot of shooting without having to drive a long ways to do it. So it's a great facility, especially if you want to bring young hunters, maybe new hunters have never had an opportunity to shoot a bird, and this is a good way to do it. We provide dogs and guides for a small fee, or you can bring your own dogs. Yeah, we've got everything that you need. We've got guns that you can rent for the day. We've got a really nice facility where you can shoot some clay targets before you go out and get into the upland, the winged birds. You know, we'll shoot some clay targets before you go out, especially if you want to do that. We built this in 94, and it's a 6,000 square foot facility. It's just, you know, it's old home week for us. We come in and all of the wood and everything was, we cut down the trees and cut the logs and stuff ourselves and made the boards. But we have a lot of people that will come out and have a meeting in the morning and then go shoot birds in the afternoon. Or the whole idea, they may come and entertain where they're going to bring, you know, 40, 80 people and have a meeting, and then we'll split up and go hunting. We can handle about 120 people a day. And that would be guided in the whole bit, whether we, you know, serving them meals and then go shoot birds, whatever.
But see how they're cutting back and forth and sniffing? Find a bird hammer. Where is it? Brody's looking for something. There we go, hen! Yeah, good shot! I was hoping it'd be that wounded rooster. Hammer, come. Hammer, come. Give. Good boy. You want to get slapped in the face a couple times, huh? Yeah. All right.
Yeah, so today we're hunting pheasant and chucker. I found out about this hunt earlier this year when Monty, guy from my shop, told me about it, asked me if I wanted to go.
So, heck yeah. So heck yeah.
Oh yeah.
Rooster! Shoot! Oh yeah! Rooster! Reload quick! Oh! Oh! No bird! All right, we got one down.
Looks like they're shooting.
Man, they're flushing them on the way to retrieve that other one. Okay.
I started this program in 2004. It's called the Military Hunting Bank, and what we do is we take active duty enlisted men and women hunting for free.
And being military, you don't really get a lot of time, so the fact that they allow you to come out and hunt their property for free, you know, that's a really great situation to end up in.
So we're able to take them. We do that every day. We set it up where we take these men and women that are active duty in every service. It's not just the Army.
The hunt or the soldiers are all, for the most part, really good shots. It's just a lot of them have shot rifles so much they're thinking they have to aim so much, and it's just, they don't realize it's just pull up, get on it, and shoot. So have to train them a little bit, you know.
My name is Michael Shores. I was kind of born into the military, so moved around a lot.
You folks in there?
My mom and my dad both Navy.
Really?
Was in California for most part of my life, Rosemont. This is actually my second duty station. I've actually came from Korea.
Really?
Been in about almost 3 years now.
We're giving back to them, they give a lot to us. So it's a great program. We've taken about 3,700 soldiers hunting over the last 12, 13 years.
Hit! Yeah! Good shot! Hand! Yeah. Oh, yeah! Oh! I hope that was a headshot. Here, hammer, come.
This is the chop house, we call it. It's our cleaning facility. It's a really nice way to... it's everything stainless inside, you know, it's hot water, and you know, we can give you fresh, frozen, vacuum sealed birds if you want to do that. Right. If not, clean up your own birds and pack them up.
Okay, take off the head. Clip the bottom of the legs off. Take and tear the skin right here. Peel the feathers all back. If you take, you stick your finger down in here, you can grab that skin.
Mm-hmm. Look at that.
Good. Pull it all right off. Then just pull back. This back. Mm-hmm. And if you want the gizzard, heart, and livers, like you would keep for a chicken or a turkey or something, you can pick those out of there. You want them? All right, and we'll just get a basket from over here on the counter.
Roger.
And put them in there and rinse them off.
It's a full-service year-round facility. The bird hunting starts the 1st of September and runs through the end of March. So during the summertime, we shoot clay targets, but you can also use the rifle range if you'd like, or the pistol range, and that's $10 for the whole day. So it's, you can come out you don't have to worry about anything. Now, we don't do the rifles and pistols as far as rentals, but it's a good place to shoot if you have your own.
We start out the hunt with Hoss Port and his hunter, Rob Aikman. It doesn't take long before this nice bull steps out to the edge of the field.
Sure. Yeah, that's a shoot. Oh, that's a shooter bull. Get your gun up. Very slowly. Okay, don't do that. John, that's a shooter bull. Oh, stop, slow down. There's elk right here to our left.
Rob barely misses this bull, shooting right under him. The next morning, they start out hearing bugles right away.
Man, you can hear them back over in there. Yeah. We just need to sneak over this hill and see if we can get a shot.
Here's a nice bull, but Rob just can't get a shot from this angle.
If you get on this side of the tree, we have a clear shot. Just breathe.
Okay. The herd of elk start moving up to the right. Now it's just trying to pick out the right bull with all these elk.
And that valley is full of elk.
Now folks, if you're looking for a hunting or fishing property right here in Colorado, we've got them backing up to BLM and National Forest, and they're starting under $100,000. So give me a call, go to my website, or hey, email me and tell me what you want and what price you want to pay. I'll find it for you.
Squeeze it off. Shoot. Oh, you got, he's standing broadside. Oh. He's standing broadside, you see?
That was some great shooting there.
Look at these elk out here.
This part of Colorado has some of the largest herds of elk in the world. It's very common to see groups of elk like this with 200, 300, 400 elk at a time. The problem with hunting big groups of elk like this is picking out the right bull and then making sure you can get a clear shot. For more information on hunting up in Northwest Colorado for bull elk, be sure and check out manversuselk.com.
Well, there's a nice bull. Look at that bull in the middle. You got a nice one laying on the ground.
Well, Rob, congratulations, man.
Thank you very much.
Tell me about what just happened.
Well, you know, they say the best idea in elk hunting is go where there's some elk. And y'all should put us on some bulls this weekend. Ended up with a shot right over here. Looks like a lung shot.
Yeah.
And guy went down. Nice 5x5.
He's a great bull. We come up over the hill this morning and what was there, 200 head?
Must have been.
Man, congratulations. Yeah,
thank you very much.
Guys, we're up here at Beaver Valley Ranch in Hayden, Colorado. For more information, go to the website or give us a call. Good job, man. Yeah.
You know, folks, I've drove Cadillacs for the past 10 years, probably the finest automobile that I've ever owned. And I know somebody that's got about 17 of them right there in Silverthorn, Colorado. Hudson Auto Source, our major sponsor. Let's go with Tim, and he'll show you a few of them right now.
Now, folks, all the dealerships in the state of Colorado are always saying, we got the best price. They argue with each other. Well, right here at Hudson Auto Source, they really do have the best price. Come to the country and see what they're all about. What makes Hudson able to lower the prices?
I mean, 40 years, buildings paid for, got great GM lines, great ownership, you know.
You know, it's a family-owned dealership. And like Tim said, it's all about having low overhead.
Right. I mean, we don't have the super big building. We don't have all the new things, but we pass that savings on to the customer, which is a great thing.
And talk about savings, folks. The incentives that GM's got coming on right now. Let's first, we're going to see several vehicles, but first, behind us, we got some coming in. We got some in stock.
I've got a total of 17 new Escalades coming in 2016. This one too right here, this is a luxury edition and it's the shorter wheelbase compared to the long ones.
Wow.
Give us the opportunity to show you what we can do. You know, I promise you the drive will be well worth it. We definitely take care of our customers up here and I mean, this is what you get. It's absolutely wonderful.
Stop him if he gets out there.
Well, Steve, you got him.
We got him.
We shot exciting. The, yeah, we shot him late last night, and we weren't sure about the shot. It was a little far back, but he didn't go 100 yards.
Yeah.
Now, folks, keep in mind that we are taking listings right now. If you've got a hunting property anywhere in the state of Colorado, we might have the buyer for you. They're looking for places to hunt right now. Also, if you've got residential property anywhere in Douglas County, we're taking listings on those also. I'm Milton Daly. We'll see you next week.
Colorado in the Wild has been brought to you by Daly Real Estate, your home and ranch specialist. Full Rut Archery. Tightline Outdoors with Nathan Zielinski. And by Rocky Mountain Roosters, Colorado's finest private pheasant hunting preserve.